Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters in Islam. Today I'm going to tell you the story of another amazing prophet, Prophet Nuh alayhi salam. Nuh alayhi salam was one of the earliest and greatest of prophets sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was during his time that idol worship first started to appear. The people made pictures and statues of righteous people who used to live among them in order to remember them. After some time, however, people began to worship these statues, and this gradually became a common practice in the next generations. They lost the understanding of asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as being the one and only one to worship. Out of mercy, Allah sent Nuh alayhi salam to guide these people to the straight path. This was 10 centuries after Adam alayhi salam. Nuh alayhi salam was an excellent speaker and a patient man. He pointed out to his people the wonders of the universe created by Allah. He explained the oneness of Allah and made them understand Tawheed, explaining the terrible punishment they would face if they continued their wrong ways. Most of the people rejected his message and mocked him. They refused to accept him as a prophet and threatened him. They continued to insult Nuh alayhi salam, but he kept on preaching them patiently for days, months, and years. They would put their fingers in their ears and became too arrogant to listen to the truth. He was sad for his people, but he never gave up hope. He continued to preach for 950 years. Ages passed and the people still wouldn't submit to truth brought by Nuh alayhi salam. A day came when Nuh alayhi salam eventually made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to destroy the disbelievers. The dua was accepted and warning came of a great punishment for the disbelievers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Nuh alayhi salam to build a ship under his instructions. His people made fun of him when they saw him constructing the ship in an area that had no rivers or seas. But he didn't stop working. He submitted to Allah's command and had complete trust in him. After the ship was complete, Nuh alayhi salam was ordered by Allah to gather the people who believed him and a pair male and female of every type of animal, bird, and insect aboard the ship. It was a three-story deck ship. The bottom deck was kept for animals and cattle, the middle deck for humans, and the upper deck was for birds. Imagine how much hard work was put into building such a magnificent ship. Subhanallah. Nuh alayhi salam's wife and son disbelieved and didn't join him. Finally, the day of the great punishment arrived. The flood came with water gushing from the cracks of the earth and rain pouring down from the sky. The earth had never witnessed such a calamity before. Nuh alayhi salam's son thought he would be saved by climbing a mountain, but a wave came and washed him away. The ship sailed over the high waves, and Allah kept all those inside it saved. The flood cleansed the earth of disbelievers and idol worshippers. By the command of Allah, the ship settled upon Mount Judi when the water seeped away in the ground and dried up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Nuh alayhi salam to descend and come out of the ship with no fear and with blessings upon him and the people who followed him. There are many lessons learnt from this story. Let's look at them together. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Nuh alayhi salam at a time when the people had completely deviated from the truth and had forgotten the teachings of Tawheed taught by Adam alayhi salam. It is from Allah's mercy that He always sends guidance to creation through prophets and messengers. He never leaves us unguided or lost. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us. Our Prophet, peace be upon him, was the last messenger who was sent to the whole of mankind and jinn. He was blessed with the Qur'an, which is a complete guide for us all till the last day. We learn from Nuh alayhi salam's story how belief in Allah must be acted upon by listening and doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us. even though building a ship on dry land where there was no water to sail didn't make sense. Nuh alayhi salam humbly submitted, believing in Allah's command. Sometimes we don't understand why our parents set some rules for us, but we follow their instructions because we trust them and know that they do everything for our benefit and our own good. What about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Who is the one who has complete knowledge? The one who is the best of planners? Shouldn't we trust Him? As a true believer, we must do what Allah asks us, even if it doesn't seem clear to us at that time. In the end, there is always a good reason behind it. We will always be safe and protected when we follow the way of Allah. Nuh alayhi salam shows us how tawakkul and full submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps us protected and safe at all times. Even though people mocked him and made fun of him for obeying Allah, he didn't stop. Obedience to Allah was more important to him than being made fun of. That is the way we should think and act too. I know for a fact that lying and using bad words is a sin. I will stay away from these things even if others laugh at me for doing this. People can make fun of me all they want, but that should not make me stop doing whatever pleases Allah. I should never feel shy about obeying my Creator. We also learn the element of patience from Nuh alayhi salam. He remained calm and continued to try to reason with his people because he cared for them. He wanted to save them from punishment. We must also be patient while correcting the mistakes of others. We are all one ummah, and it is required from us to take care for one another. This is why we should adopt the proper way in showing people the right path by never belittling or insulting them. We clearly see that this was not the way of our prophets. If my younger brother or sister doesn't know how to pray properly, I must teach them in a kind manner. If they take something without permission, I should not accuse them of stealing. Rather, I must explain to them the correct way of asking permission. We also learn how our prophets always asked for Allah's help while delivering the message of truth. They all faced hardships and opposition from their people, and they always turned to Allah for assistance. They understood that all help comes only from Allah, and so we follow their example in this regard too, where we always turn to Allah for help in all circumstances. I hope you all benefited from this great story. Insha'Allah, I'll be back next week with another story of our great prophets. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.